everyone, welcome back to my channel. Come learn and grow with me. So today I actually want to talk with you all about how we do things for two reasons. One, to gain pleasure, and two, being to avoid pain. And I found the perfect example in this book, Awaken the Giant Within by Anthony Robbins, same person. And it's the perfect example. I'm going to share it with you in just a second, but he really explains so well how our behaviors are linked to pleasure and pain. So it's really interesting in this book. I absolutely love this book. So I'm going to share a little part of it here with you, and it's a little short part. And it's a great example, though. So, a simple example of this occurred with my daughter Jolene's ex-boyfriend. Jolene was very busy with school, dance, and a play she was in. He wanted her to call him every single day, and when she missed a few days and then called him, he gave her tremendous amounts of pain. He clearly wanted her to call more frequently, yet his strategy for reinforcement was to badger and berate her when she did call. Have you ever been guilty of this? If you want your boyfriend, girlfriend, spouse, or significant other to call you more often, how effective do you think it would be to nag them to call? When they finally do call, do you greet them with statements like, "Oh, so you finally picked up the phone? Well, wonders never cease. Why do I always have to be the one who makes the call?" What you're doing is training him or her not to call you. You're given pain right after they do the very thing you want. What will happen as a result of this? Pain will be linked to calling you. He or she will avoid it even more in the future. In Jolie's case, this pattern was continuous, going on for months, until Jolie felt that she couldn't win. If she didn't call, she'd get pain. If she did call, she'd get pain. As you might guess, this pattern of negative reinforcement permeated many aspects of the relationship, and eventually, the relationship ended. If you truly want someone to call you, then when they do call you, you need to respond with delight. If you tell them how much you miss them, how much you love them, how grateful you are to talk with them, do you think that they'll be more inclined to call again? Remember, link pleasure to any behavior you want someone to repeat. So it's so important to monitor our behaviors as well, because oftentimes we don't even realize what we're doing because it's all subconscious. It's all in the mind, you guys. Our subconscious mind controls like 95% of our life. 95% of our life is on autopilot subconscious mind. It's our subconscious mind running our life, most of it. So it's super important to learn about your mind and how it works and learn how about the subconscious mind as well, because that runs a huge part of our lives, and it's super important to realize what it is that you have linked up in your subconscious to pain and to pleasure, and how you can transform it, because in this book, it definitely tells you how to transform your emotions, so you can take your bad habits and connect them to pain, and take the habits you want to incorporate and link them to pleasure, and it's so amazing. Tony Robbins explains it so well in this book. It is quite a thick book, but it's a great read, and you learn so much knowledge from this book. So I definitely encourage you to check this book out if you're a reader, and I'm sure they have an audio version somewhere you could find if you like to just listen to audiobooks as well, because audiobooks are also amazing. So however you want to incorporate your knowledge, but definitely look into the subconscious mind and how to control your mind so you can figure out your own programs and what they are that you have, and you can observe your behaviors and figure out what it is that you're doing that you could improve yourself. Because remember, we can only improve ourselves. We can't control other people. We can only control ourselves and our behaviors and what we do. And everything is mirrored back to us, you guys. So also remember that as well. So with that being said, have a wonderful, amazing day, and definitely observe your own belief systems and your own behaviors and see where you need improvement in your life. Have a wonderful day, you guys. Love, light, and blessings to you all always. Thank you so much for watching. Be sure to give me a thumbs up if you liked it, And be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Peace.